Welcome to another edition of Fitness Friday Positives with Rachelle, folks. I am so excited. I'm here at Bel Air Fitness, my old stomping ground in Bossier City, Louisiana. Folks, I just wanted to share a quick thought here on the value of frequency on your fitness journey, particularly fitness frequency of your fitness routine. So a lot of people wonder, you know, why I work out, I struggle still, my weight hasn't changed in the last 5 years. I've been going to the gym, I've been working out, I've been going to this particular fitness class, whatever the case may be. Won't get into all of the variables, but I just wanted to narrow it down to one particular variable in terms of your fitness success, and that being having a good level of frequency in terms of the number of times that you work out. So, sometimes when people talk about, or just a general conversation, tell me about some of their fitness challenges and how they're struggling, and they don't understand why, I'll ask them a question like, how often do you work out? You know, what do you do? Whatever it is. Won't get into all of these deep, in-depth conversations, but frequency is often something that I highlight because, unfortunately, a lot of people mistakenly believe that showing up to any type of fitness facility or working out, even at home, they've got an exercise DVD, whatever the case may be, one time a week is going to be enough. And you know Rachelle's going to tell you the truth. And if that's you right now, again, this is not to condemn anyone, to make anyone feel bad about themselves, but I want to challenge you to increase your frequency in terms of your workout, in terms of working out at home, wherever it is. You need to make sure that you've got a decent frequency. There's health guidelines that say 3 or more times a week, certain, you know, just do what works for you, particularly if you may have 2 or 3 jobs and working out is tough, but I challenge you. Someone who's been struggling for 5 years and 10 years and thinking that they're going to show up to a gym once a week, once a month, once a year, in many cases, you're just wasting your time. I mean, there's just no other way to describe it. I mean, there's a school of thought that says something is better than nothing. You know, going to the gym once a month is better than not going at all. And I just want to challenge you, and this isn't to make anyone feel bad about themselves, but I just want to challenge you to increase your frequency. You want to make sure you're in there. You want to make sure that it's a routine. One thing I often state, you know, the Rachelle-ism, I've been saying this for years now, is you will only succeed at fitness when it becomes a lifestyle and not an event. And so a lifestyle means it's built into your daily routine, it's built into your daily life. You cannot neglect your fitness and expect to be successful. Particularly in the long term, and I think about, you know, when I first started going to the Barksdale Air Force Base Fitness Center, ironically, which is probably about a good 2.5-3 miles from here, just literally down that road is Barksdale. When I got my start, you know, I used to go 5 days a week, and here I am 25 years later going 5 to 6 days a week. And I was a powerhouse to go 6 days a week, or 6 mornings, always in the morning, 6 mornings a week, but my frequency has always been high. And part of that is, you know, I want the freedom. There's freedom and then there's discipline. So I have the discipline to come into a fitness facility 5 to 6 days a week, 5 to 6 mornings a week, because I want freedom at the dinner table. I don't want to be counting calories. I don't want to care. I don't want to care about how many calories something has. I'm going to eat what I want to eat. I'm very disciplined, of course, in terms of my meal times and all of that, but I just want that type of freedom. Freedom is just an overall very important thing in my life, so that's a very big motive and driver for me. In terms of just the discipline, working out. Sure, I'm putting my time into the gym, but I just love fitness. I'm very passionate about fitness. I'm passionate about health. And so I just want to encourage you, perhaps if you're struggling with your frequency, can you join a group fitness class? That's certainly something I've never done, but that works for a lot of people in terms of accountability, in terms of motivation, in terms of helping you get and keep going, help you keep going on your fitness journey. Group fitness is a great option, or perhaps it could be working with a personal trainer. That's certainly something that people find beneficial. I've never done it myself, but you can explore that option as well. So there's different things in terms of accountability that you can do. Work out with a workout buddy, your best friend, your spouse, whoever the case may be, someone that you admire in terms of their fitness. You know, ask to work out with them once or twice or something to get some tips and all of that. But just ask yourself, do I need a short-term boost of motivation, or is it something I just have no motivation at all? You've got to devise a plan to get going, get moving, and increase your frequency. And so that's all I have for you today, folks. Do not deceive yourself into thinking going once a month or twice a month is going to benefit you. You know, you want to make sure, you know, cardio aspect of your routine, really, really helping your cardiovascular system. A few years ago, I did an episode with Dr. Mark Leibus, who's a very well-respected cardiologist in the Metro Detroit area. And he talked about just the value of your cardiovascular, your working out, particularly the cardio routines, to your cardiovascular health, and how that impacts long-term survival, long-term health, and their strength training. There's just so many different ways that fitness benefits your health. And I always want you to be successful. I want you to have a long life. I want you to be just successful beyond your greatest dreams in terms of your fitness. Because your health is something that is so precious to all of us. Lose it at any time. There's things we can control, things we can't control. So control what you can control and really get yourself up, get yourself going, get yourself moving in terms of your fitness journey. So folks, that's it. I thank you so much for your time. And to remember, I am positively passionate about your fitness and success. Make it a great day.